At this point, I'm pretty happy with what we've come up with. This is very close to the design. So now it's time to capture all of the style changes that we've made into our file. So far, we've made these changes in the browser, but as soon as we refresh, these changes will be gone. I'm going to jump back to our text editor. Now, earlier on in this series, what we did to add styles was use the style property. So we'd do style equals, and then quotes, and we'd put our styles right in there. And we can do that now. Let's give that a shot. I'm going to jump back to the browser. And what I'll do here is highlight all of the styles. So notice I'm starting from where this bracket begins and ending the selection before the ending bracket. And then I can right click and copy. And then I'll jump back to the editor and I'll paste right inside this style section. And I'll save this. Now we can jump back to the browser and refresh. And you see that all of our changes persist because we have it in the style tag inside of our code right here. Now, the style property is very useful, but in general, it's not the way that we want to apply styles in our HTML for a couple of reasons. The first is the one that should be kind of obvious here, which is that as we get longer styles, it becomes harder and harder to tell what our HTML structure is. We could remove all of the extra lines in order to make this all one line, but then it would be even harder to read. And if you imagine HTML elements nested in other HTML elements, this is going to start to get a bit unwieldy. But that's not the biggest reason why we don't use a style tag. The biggest problem is when we want to reuse styles. So let's say we have three heading 2 tags, and we can simulate that by copying this h2 tag and pasting it in here a couple times. So now we have 3 of them. I'll save this, and we'll go to the browser and refresh. So you'll see qualities 3 times. Okay, all is good so far, right? Well, let's say now we want to change the letter spacing in all 3 of these because we're just a little bit short of what we want and we'd rather extend it out a little bit. What will we need to do? Well, we have to go back into our code and we're going to need to change it in 3 different places. So letter spacing here, letter spacing here, and letter spacing here. Now that doesn't seem like a huge deal because we only have 3 headings and they're all right next to each other. But when we're done with this template, the h2 tags are going to be distributed throughout a whole bunch of other HTML code, and it's going to be a surprising amount of work trying to find all of the headings that use this style in order to modify it. So ultimately, we'll end up using something called a selector in order to tell the browser which elements get certain styles, instead of putting the styles in line with the element. Let's do that. So if you remember from before when we were explaining why we use the HTML head body structure inside of our document, part of it was that our head is useful for other things besides just the title, and one of them is for putting styles in it. So what we'll start with is a starting style tag, and we'll just go ahead and end that as well so we don't forget. And then within this style tag, we're going to use a selector. I'll go ahead and type out the selector now and then explain what it means. Okay, so what we have here is H2, which you should be familiar with by now. It's our heading 2 tag. And so we're saying with this selector that we want to apply any styles that are inside of these curly brackets to H2 tags. We could put any tag here if we wanted. And we can do a lot more with selectors, which you'll see shortly in this series. So now, instead of having our styles here, let's cut out these styles and we'll paste it inside this selector. Notice how everything gets indented properly. This is another benefit of using an IDE instead of a plain text editor. And now that we have this, we can remove the style tag from all of our H2s. Okay, let's save it and jump back to the browser and refresh. And you'll notice that nothing changed here. Down here, instead of all of the styles appearing in element.style, we're seeing it inside of this selector. And we can demonstrate very quickly how powerful it is to be using a selector instead. So let's say we wanted to change the color to blue. So I'm going to highlight the value and type in blue. And you can see that the styles change across all of our headers at once. So hopefully you can see the power of switching from using the style property to using the style tag and specifying selectors to apply styles to. Now, like I said, we can do a lot more with selectors and we'll need to in just a few steps in order to get what we need. But for now, this is pretty good.